Before we bring you the last of the 40 by 20 championship action in the series, we take you to Broadford in Limerick for the last of our clubs in focus.
When we all started off as young kids, we had a man, Patty Doodia. He literally dragged us into the courts, got the whole thing going. He took us to Fela 20 odd years ago. I say he retired there maybe 8-9 years ago, and it went into a big lull since. So it was great, like, for just for the club, the parish, to get back into the 60 by 30. It was the main win, like, it was 60 by 30 was dying away for us. So that was our biggest achievement, definitely for the juveniles. The ladies, they help out, they do it, they do it all behind the scenes. I mean, you walk in here, and the place is clean, the place is tidy. You take it for granted. Any day we have a crowd, any day that matches, there's always food laid on. Very lucky, one day I met there Siobhan Mahan. She had won her number 17 All-Ireland title. She'd gone away then, done her teaching course. And just pure luck, I met her in the post office one day. Chance my arm, would she coach a couple of kids. She took them on, and within 6 months, she had 35 of the school kids. But the best part about it was half of them were girls. It's friendly, you can come in here in the evening time, even not to play it. You can sit in the gallery watching a game. There's two lads training. There's four or five more there. You can sit down and have a chat. It's comfortable. It's like home there in the evening. It's more like a family.
I started off in bar, like, it was Tom and Brian. They came out to my office and they said to me that we're stuck for a player, like, would you play? So I didn't even know what a handball was, like, and I just stood in and served a few balls and stuff with my cousin, Philly Clancy. And we ended up winning the county final that time, or under 10 or something, but that was very good, like, to know that time, because I didn't even know what a handball was.
0-0.
The GAA Handball All-Ireland Men's Open Doubles Championship concluded with a fascinating battle between Meath and Cavan. Cavan duo Brady and Finnegan were really on top in the opening game in front of the large home crowd.
Jim, where did I go wrong? My life's a bargain basement, all the good shit's gone. I'm just getting old a job, where do I belong? But sleeping in my car, my dreams move on. My name is Billy G, my love is bought and sold. I'm only 16, I feel 100 years old.
We're talking here about the reigning 40 by 20 senior doubles champions against the reigning 60 by 30 senior doubles champions. So just shows how good all of these players are in doubles. They've won so many titles between them. But puts the ball down the left, and once again see Brian Carroll back over in the left with the left hand.
Brian is doing off of a couple of rallying down there, like, and Tom just allows him to do it because he knows what he is.
Yeah, Tom, even at 42 years of age, Tom is probably most comfortable inside because he's an amazing picker inside, isn't he?
He's not. Tom's actually 43 today.
I'm 43, yeah.
43 today, and look at him in there, you wouldn't think he was 43, if I tell you the truth. But,
Brady in the singles final last week, he's a class above every other player in the country at the minute, Robbie, isn't he, in terms of the singles play in the 40 by 20. So far, this has been an almost perfect performance by Paul and Michael for Cavan here. The two boys really, really in hot form here today in Kingscourt.
Brian's right hand here, he's going to go up for like two.
Oh, what a shot.
Great shot. Brian's right corner.
When Paul hits the ball with full force behind it, it's be very well to get it back. Oh, what a shot by Paul Brady.
That opening game win put them firmly in the driving seat. The second proved to be a much more keenly contested affair.
To save here now. They're 2-0 down in the second game. Very important here, Robbie, that Meath get a few points on the board now.
Oh, that's a great comeback.
A lot of points. That's 6 points in a row now.
The amount of shots that are going through, 20, maybe 25 shots in a rally. You know, it's just a joy to watch.
but there's a long way to go. Even in this second game, there's a long, long way to go.
Someday I'll be selling night, I'll be back on my feet, I'll be doing alright. It may not be tomorrow, baby, that's okay. I ain't going down, I'm gonna find a way.
This is absolutely quality stuff here at the minute. Robbie,
boys, oh, okay.
Oh, this is a chance for Tom.
Tom will go for
it. Oh, yes, he's done. What a shot.
Just stick the hand out.
Yeah, and he said that Paul was going to try and finish this game off. And that's exactly what he's in the process of trying to do at the minute. From 15-18 to 19-18. One more point and they're in game ball.
Oh, what a shot by Labour.
For the match, another All-Ireland senior title. That is long, long list.
And Meath have done it once again.
Back in.
That's a tall order now for Brian and Tom. They can't afford. There's no more room for error. Paul goes for it, and Tom gets it. He goes for it again. This is amazing handball here at the minute. This is Paul's chance now to win it. Oh, Brian's got it. This is remarkable handball. Michael goes for it.
We're all going for it.
This is amazing stuff, Robbie, here.
Now it's coming back. Paul is going to go for this.
Oh, what a shot by Paul Brady.
Great
way
to
play.
Yep.
He won an amazing rally.
That impressive final kill shot brought the title to Cavan for a sixth time. There is no doubt it was a big year for Paul Brady, and for Michael Finnegan, another major highlight followed.
Just a busy year, because we got engaged early in the year this year, and then we said we'd get married in November, so the handball came in between, so it's a good year, and hopefully we'll have a good finish to it now, a good day today, and by the way, on honeymoon next week, so it's a good year.
That's the second love. So it sounds like happy. I'll go and watch the matches. I'll be nervous. He's good at it, so might as well continue at it.
We hope that this latest GAA Handball Show series has provoked further significant interest in the sport for you. Keep an eye out for more of that build-up, and for now, enjoy our glance back at the GAA Handball highlights from our series. And remember to tune in again next time. Strain this chaos, turn it into light.
It's so clear now that you are all that I have.
There is no doubt that you will hear a great deal more throughout 2012 as GAA Handball Ireland continues with plans for the biggest World Handball Championship event in history, this coming October in Dublin.